start off to make our hub. Start off with our log of timber. If anybody didn't hear, so just like the stringy bark, slave purpose only. Iron bark will be used for a working hub. Deep bark, I cut it roughly the length. You can bore a tapered hole through the centre off to start off with. away from the end.
Yep.
This one needs around 18, nearly 18 acres. We lose a certain percentage, naturally crashing, there's not much we can do about it. We'll dry it back to the end, leave a bit of undercoat on it, try to slow the drying process down a little bit. Pull the hub out of there, check it. We've got no major cracks, and we come back and recut the board. Get them to the right size. We'll start off with our billet of timber. And same as on the other side, only a local mesonite hot one for display purpose only. Quarter guns will be used for work and spoke. Start off this billet to go with the spoke laid at the back. And that will very quickly get rugged. This one is supposed to be a rectangular cut on the end, as you'll see in a minute. And I'll turn it down to a basic spoke shape. Second part, cut the tenon on the end of it. And this is green timber too, obviously. This is always cut oversized to start off with. Then the last part, throw to the spoke. That's a very important part of the spoke. One, it gives a little bit of flexibility, the narrowest part of the spoke. But most importantly, it takes most of the shock, a lot of the shock and vibration out. Pretty solid of the roads, very solid wheels. Travels up there, narrowest part here. The vibrations get faster and then disperses the worst of out of there before it gets to the centre of the wheel. Originally a draw knife and spoke shave to do that. A good Wheelwright in his day can do up to 15 of them at the most in a day by hand. With this machinery we can do up to 2,000 in a day. That's one man on the three different machines. This is the tenning machine. real deal iron bar, it's got to come by a bit of extra spokes in, quite a tight fit. We get our set of spokes out, once they've dried, so they do crank up a fair bit, sand them all up, recut the tenons to the right size, the chamfer on one side of it. The main reason for that is, and this is the wrong hub for these spokes, when it goes down to a very tight fit, it literally only gets about a third of the way down before it's locked up side to side, from end to end I should say. Just help guide it in there a little bit easier. And because of the pressure of it, we just put every second spoke in, leaving out the pressure. We try to force one in after the other, all that'll end up happening is our gap will just close up as we go around. So by putting every second one in, evening out, and we just come back to the beginning, fill in the rest of the holes. And sorry, we normally have it set up to dry spokes and do everything, but we've just sold a couple of wheels today that were being done. So basically, once all our spokes are in, it's almost that. Steam bending, we have down this end, we've got a couple of steam bolts in the left wall, boiler, and a big bender down the far end. A lot of equipment to have. The beauty of a fellow is all we need is a set of templates. Put them on a block of timber, trace them out, cut them out. And to put them onto the wheel,
this one here, that was a fairly high volume pump, but the pressure only went up to about, I think 1150 PSI.
Mm-hmm.
And then I thought,